If I were to ask you what's the largest thing to have ever lived on planet Earth, most people would say the blue whale, of course. But despite popular belief, it's not. So, what on Earth is? Or should I say, was?
I'm Stu, this is Debunked, and we're here to sort the truths from the myths and the facts from the misconceptions. Okay, so if the blue whale sets the benchmark by which all other living creatures are measured, it probably makes sense to first establish just how big a blue whale can get.
The biggest one ever discovered was found in the Southern Ocean of Antarctica back in 1947. It weighed in at a hefty 190 metric tons, which is the equivalent to 104 standard family SUVs. It also measured a huge 27.6 meters long, close to the length of a short-haul airliner. And its estimated volume was roughly the size of 7 fuel trucks at 223 cubic meters. Remember that for later.
What could possibly outsize something this massive? Well, whales first appeared around 40 million years ago.
So to find out what could possibly top such a titan, it makes sense to take a look at this prehistoric era of Earth's history. When great monstrous-sized beasts walked the planet, plants were the size of VWs, and colossal creatures swam in our oceans. So, let's start with dinosaurs, or more accurately, titanosaurs, a group of four-legged vegesauruses with long tails and small heads. The largest of these dinosaurs to have ever walked on the Earth is believed to be the Argentinosaurus. Its discovery in the 1990s stunned paleontologists the world over, with a length of 35 meters and a weight of 70 metric tons. Put this next to most people's common point of dino size reference, the T-Rex, and it dwarfs the goat-eating carnivore. However, the title was hotly contended in 2017 by the discovery of the Patagotitan maiorum. This titanosaur was believed to have a skeleton 10% larger than the Argentinosaurus, but recent weight estimations put it just shy of 69 tons. Both titanosaurs may be longer than the whale, but put both the Argentinosaurus and the Patagotitan on a set of scales, and the pair together wouldn't outweigh our big blue heifer. In fact, whales are so much larger because they live in the ocean. On land, animals suffer the full effect of gravity, but for sea-based organisms, the water's buoyancy is believed to reduce the strain on their muscles and skeletons, allowing them to grow to such vast sizes. When something as huge as a blue whale becomes beached or stranded on land, their muscles can't support their body weight out of the water, and they will basically be crushed to death under their own weight.
So, with the ocean providing the best environment for a creature to supersize itself, let's take a look into the deep blue, more specifically the Cretaceous period, to see what competition there would have been.
Now, anyone who's witnessed this scene before will surely think that this prehistoric monster offers some competition for a blue whale. That is a mosasaur, and that is a great white shark serving as an amuse-bouche. Now, if this is your average size great white, then the mosasaur would make up the length of about 9 of these sharks. With your average great white measuring in at 5.3 meters, that means the mosasaur measures in at nearly 48 meters. And this is how our blue whale sizes up against this leviathan. But here's where Hollywood gets carried away with itself. Mosasaurs aren't believed to have grown any longer than 18 meters, with the largest one to have ever been excavated sitting at a modest 15 meters, meaning Jurassic World's reptile is grossly inaccurate.
Anyway, that's enough science fiction. Let's get back to the science fact. What is the largest dinosaur to have ever swam in our oceans?
Fortunately, a discovery in 2018 may have the answer. Measuring in at nearly 26 meters, that's only just short of our largest blue whale, it's believed that this giant ichthyosaur may have been the largest aquatic reptile ever. However, with its dolphin-like shape, a long pointy jaw and streamlined body, its estimated weight falls far below that of the whale, meaning the blue whale still stands as the largest animal to have ever swam in our planet's waters. Let's leave the wet stuff behind now and head back to land, where the competition to be crowned largest living thing is starting to hot up. What stands taller than the largest dinosaurs and doesn't suffer the effect of gravity like other living, breathing organisms? The trees. As we travel to the coast of California, we'll find the Redwoods National Park. And here, you'll see Hyperion. Even fantasy doesn't top this living behemoth. Take a recent incarnation of Godzilla and put it next to the sequoia, and it stands around 10% taller, at a staggering 115.85 meters. And if Godzilla's not your thing, then take a look at how the Statue of Liberty sizes up. Yet height isn't everything. We're after the largest, and that doesn't necessarily mean the tallest. So for that, we need to travel down the coast to meet General Sherman, a 2,100-year-old giant sequoia. He may stand at a humble 82.6 meters tall by comparison, but has a whopping volume of 1,487 cubic meters, blowing old Bluey out of the water. Because in fact, you could squeeze around 7 blue whales inside this tree. When the general's root system is taken into account, it's believed that this single organism would weigh 1,814 tons. And as astounding as those stats are, there was once a tree larger than the general, measuring at 1,727 cubic meters, but it was sadly cut down in the 1940s. However, even with these giants of the forest, we've still not found the largest living thing to have ever lived on our planet. To find what we're looking for, we need to travel to the Blue Mountains of eastern Oregon. And here, we won't find the largest living organism towering over the forest, swimming through the lakes, or stomping around the mountains. Instead, we need to look below our feet. Under the forest floor of the Malua National Forest, you'll find something that you may not have expected to come out on top in this video. While we've been looking at all the relevant kingdoms of life on planet Earth, there's one we're forgetting. Fungi, or fungi, or fungi, depending on where you're from. Here on the ground, we find the Armillaria astoi, or more commonly known as the honey fungus. All we generally see is the fruiting body, what we would consider a mushroom or toadstool. But this is often only a 10% of a fungus. The rest of the organism, the vegetative part, is below the earth. To make this concept more familiar, imagine this is a fruit tree, and you'd see the leaves, branches, and stems all below ground, with only the fruit appearing above. This fungus, however, is no ally to trees. The honey fungus is actually devouring the forest from the ground up.
Now, most people won't think of fungi as tree killers, as they're in fact a cornerstone to the entire ecosystem of a forest, usually breaking down organic debris like fallen leaves and transferring essential minerals to the plants. Here, however, the Armillaria astoi has a much more parasitic purpose.
It attaches itself to the forest conifer trees and begins to feed off of their roots, killing the tree in the process. Nicknamed the humongous fungus, the wealth of trees in this area has enabled it to spread far and wide. And currently, this fungi stretches across 2,200 acres, or 8.9 square kilometers, below the soil. To put what you are seeing here into perspective, that is the equivalent of around 1,700 NFL football fields, or 36,500 tennis courts.
Now, the discovery of the humongous fungus sparked debate as to what constitutes a single living organism.
But it can be succinctly summed up by biology professor Tom Volk.
It's one set of genetically identical cells that are in communication with one another, that have a sort of common purpose, or at least can coordinate themselves to do something.
Which is exactly what the honey fungus is, meaning this is indeed a single living organism, just like the giant sequoia or the blue whale. And it's not just the extensive area it covers that makes the Armillaria astoi so huge. Its discoverer, James B. Anderson from the University of Toronto, recently surveyed the site and now estimates that if the entire fungus were dug up out of the ground and weighed, it would top the scales at 400 tons, more than double the heft of a blue whale.
As with anything at this scale, it brings with it some controversy. There is another single living organism spread over a vast area that is touting for the same title of largest living organism.
Head down to Utah and you'll find this huge tree. Nope, back out a little. There. This is one tree. Known as the Trembling Giant, or Pando, Latin for I spread, this entire grove of 47,000 quaking aspen trees has grown from a single root system. You see, aspens find most success in regenerating vegetatively, meaning sprouting from roots, not from seedlings. This results in what's termed a clone. Just like the honey fungus, this forest is genetically identical, and it behaves as one organism. With the changing seasons, the whole forest changes colour and sheds all its leaves in unison. And most fascinatingly, as an old tree dies in the colonial grove, signals are sent from the tree out to the network of roots, which then stimulate new growth for the next generation to replace the old. Now, this colony may look substantially more impressive than the humble honey fungus, but we're only looking at 106 acres, less than 5% of the area covered by the fungus.
So surely there's no competition. Well, the complications come when weight is included in the criteria.
As we've learnt, the humongous fungus weighs in at 400 tons, whereas it's estimated that Pando smashes through that record, weighing a colossal 6,000 tons. In fact, the United States Department of Agriculture lists both Pando and the humongous fungus as the largest organism on Earth.
Pando is believed to be the largest, most dense organism ever found. The Malheur National Forest, location of the world's largest living organism, the humongous fungus.
So, surely the only way that this can be settled is to confirm it with the great holders of such titles over at the Guinness World Records.
Well, no. The record for the largest living organism seems so controversial that even Guinness haven't yet declared it. According to their records, Pando is confirmed as the most massive plant, while the honey fungus holds the record for largest fungi. The most common criteria, however, that declares anything as largest is specified under area covered. And under this, the humongous honey fungus is the outright winner. Even if you took into account the total estimated volume of the two contenders, then the Armillaria estoi decimates the quaking aspen at more than double its size. Pando is, however, believed to hold the slightly less grandiose record for largest known organism on Earth in terms of dry weight mass, as fungi are around 92% water. On the other hand, the humongous fungus has increased in size with subsequent surveys, whereas, sad but true, Pando is dying. It has substantially reduced over the past 70 years due to human interference, and it's thought that within the next 10 to 20 years, up to 80% of the entire grove could collapse. Dr. Paul Rogers, an ecologist who recently led a conservation effort to protect Pando, has said,
"If we can save this, there are lessons that may help us save hundreds to thousands of species worldwide. If we can't manage that 106 acres and restore it, what does that say about our greater interactions with the Earth?"
Thanks for watching. This is the first video we've released in a while, but we are now committed to producing regular content for Debunked, so watch out for our upcoming releases. In the meantime, check out our video on screen now, and thank you for your continued support.